Okay, so this is the question seven. It says, choose the statement below, which most correctly explains how mathematical computer models allow us to understand what is going on inside of the cell. And hopefully the word model reminds you of something that we covered in module two. We talked about laws, theories, and models. And what applied to models is it's a calculational tool. It allows you to calculate the things that you can maybe directly observe to figure out what things really are. Think of the heliocentric model and geocentric model. And what those models allow you to calculate are the positions of the planets in the sky. Some models, heliocentric model, represents the real, true world better. So with that in mind, let's just read through each of the choices and see how the description here fits into how we understand what a model is as a calculational tool. So it says the computer model of the solar interior explains the apparent, So whenever you build a model, you do rely on your laws of nature as you know them. You don't build models that somehow violate known laws. And depending on the complexity of the model, you might be using what we might describe as a theory, as in more comprehensive set of interlocking laws that describe a particular situation. But the moment it says a violation of law of conservation of energy, no, that's not what models do. Models are built on known laws and theories. So not that. Mathematical computer models allow us to extrapolate the conditions in the sun's core, temperature of almost 15 million kelvins and unimaginably high pressure. That sounds about right. You know, I don't actually remember the actual temperature. It might be higher than this, like 100 million Kelvin. Let's keep reading. From the surface temperature of the sun, about 6,000 Kelvin. Okay. Which allows us to better understand better the conditions of Earth's core. Unrelated. Sun is a ball of a hot gas plasma made up of mostly hydrogen and helium. Earth is made up of mostly metal or metal and silicates, iron core. So the kind of models you would build for the sun, a model involving quite a bit of nuclear physics, nuclear fusion, is totally different from model we would build for Earth. I mean, in building model for Earth, you might account for nuclear decay. So that's one of the processes that helps keep the Earth's core hot, but not nuclear fusion. So in a statement like this, if one part is wrong, then the entire statement is wrong. So that's wrong. Okay. But you know, without this, it could have been right. Although I think this number is deliberately wrong. I think it's hundreds of million kelvins. And yeah. Mathematical computer models beautifully illustrate the symmetry of our model of the sun. This mathematical elegance, okay, yeah, this is a statement which is meant to be the basis of, we don't judge models on the basis of mathematical elegance. I mean, there is a such thing as Occam's razor, I think that's the phrase. All things being equal, the simplest explanation is the probably right one. So we do prefer mathematically elegant models, but that's not the ultimate criteria. Ultimate criterion is what our models predict has to agree with what we actually can measure. So that gets us to the last choice here. The computer model of the solar interior makes predictions that can be tested with outside observations. Yeah, heliocosmology, that's based on the observations of what's going on at the surface of the sun, and solar neutrinos. They come directly from the core of the sun, but the property of neutrino makes it so that they can travel through the sun and arrive at our detectors, among others. Thus, the model gives us an idea of the interior of the sun that we cannot directly observe. Yeah, that's correct. And that's the basis on which we might say the core of the sun is at a particular temperature. We have a model where there are some tunable parameters that we fit to yield the observed results, like surface temperature 6,000 Kelvin. And within that model, you can look at then, okay, given all this everything that we fit to, what is the temperature at the core? And I think that's like hundreds of millions of Kelvin. So this is too low, I think. But you know, you don't have to memorize that. That's why I have this part that makes the choice wrong.